Some say, if you can focus on one thing for 25 minutes without getting distracted, that's a great start. If you can do that over and over, you can achieve almost anything in the world. After hearing this, do you feel a surge of excitement, eager to get started right away? However, many people find that using the Pomodoro technique isn't as easy as it sounds. What am I doing wrong? Before you dive into your first Pomodoro, maybe check out this video. You might find the answers you're looking for. Work for 25 minutes, rest for 5 minutes, and repeat. This is the simplest understanding of the Pomodoro technique. But have you ever wondered why you should divide your time this way? I mean, what's the core idea behind the Pomodoro technique? It's because our brains can only focus for so long before we start losing concentration. By breaking up time into smaller Pomodoros with short breaks, you can keep your focus sharp and get more done. Also, tracking and analyzing your focus and time usage with the Pomodoro technique can help you understand your daily workload better and see where your time is going. So, we can conclude that the Pomodoro technique is not just about alternating between focus and rest. It involves 4 steps: planning, doing, tracking, and analyzing. Planning can be divided into 2 parts: scheduling and estimating. Write down everything you need to do and plan your tasks for the day. Once planned, estimate how many Pomodoros each task will take. Setting estimated Pomodoros serves 2 purposes. First, it sets a time limit for yourself. If you think a task will take 4 Pomodoros or 2 hours, it stops you from stretching it to 6 or 8 Pomodoros or even wasting the whole day. The estimated Pomodoros act like a deadline, pushing you to finish. Second, it helps you plan reasonably. After all, a day's time is limited, meaning the number of Pomodoros is limited too. Make sure the estimated Pomodoros for all your tasks don't exceed your available time. If they do, move some tasks to tomorrow. Estimating Pomodoros also helps you get into the focus state more easily. In practice, if a task is estimated to take more than 7 Pomodoros, break it down into smaller subtasks. This way, you won't be overwhelmed and avoid starting. After all, it's all about taking manageable steps. Additionally, small tasks like replying to emails or signing documents, which take less than 1 Pomodoro, should be combined into a single POMO to avoid disrupting your Pomodoro rhythm. In the doing phase, it's crucial to understand. With a set work and rest rhythm, you shouldn't arbitrarily switch tasks or interrupt a Pomodoro. Otherwise, you won't maintain focus, and the designated break times become meaningless. If any unavoidable interruptions occur, abandon that Pomodoro. Furthermore, if you're easily distracted by external factors like social media notifications or friends' invitations, try using white noise and full screen mode. With sounds of rain or flowing water, keep your timer in full screen mode. This might help you enter a flow state faster. Sometimes internal distractions occur, such as random thoughts. When this happens, don't exit focus. Jot down the idea in a focus note for later and quickly return to your current Pomodoro. Of course, some people can maintain long periods of focus, while others need more frequent breaks to stay attentive. If a 25-minute Pomodoro is too long or too short for you, adjust the duration in focus settings under timer option to find the rhythm that works best for you. Tip: when increasing the Pomodoro duration, also increase the break time accordingly to ensure you have enough time to relax and recharge. Finally, don't forget to analyze your focus data, which is another core aspect of the Pomodoro technique. Many people execute without reviewing. This means they don't know what went wrong or how to improve. To better track your data, some preparation is needed before starting a Pomodoro. First, before focusing, you can link a task or habit to the Pomodoro, ensuring the time is logged accurately for review. Second, Use focus timer for tasks that require long-term dedication, like exercise or reading, to track data more effectively. With a data foundation, periodically analyze your data. First, analyze the discrepancy between estimated and actual time for each task. This helps you understand the actual time required for each task, improving future planning and Pomodoro estimation. Second, count interruptions and their reasons. Summarize the frequent distractions and consider how to avoid them. Third, review the distribution of focused hours each day. This helps identify your most productive times, allowing you to schedule important tasks during those periods for optimal workflow.